Oh, hey guys, you made it. This is the final video in the Introduction to Photoshop series, video 4 of 4. Okay, so we've talked a lot about the different things that Photoshop can do and how David Shevlin created these awesome paintings that are showcased here and also used in the class. There's a link in the description to the visual effects class that I'm working on. So this last video is kind of a catch-all. It's all the stuff that I didn't quite get to in the other videos of what Photoshop can do, things that I commonly use. Okay, so we learned a little bit about undo. If you go to the history panel, here's like some different things that are showing up here and stuff that we can do. So if I like brush, I don't want to use green. So if I hold Alt, I can do, I don't know if you wanted to like do whatever, right? With this crazy brush. And then it's got these 4 brush strokes. Now, if I hit Control Z multiple times, it undoes up through the list. You see the history goes up and up. If I hit Control Shift Z, it comes back down. Now, this is different than it used to be in Photoshop. It used to be that Control Z was, now is Control Alt Z, where it toggles between the last and the most recent. Oh my gosh, it's like not quite working. Okay, Control-Alt-Z does this, right? Or it toggles between them. Used to be that was just Control-Z, and now Control-Z is what used to be Control-Shift-Z, and Control-Shift-Z is something. It's all very confusing, I apologize, but if you play around with it, you'll know from your version of Photoshop what it is. Control-Y, which used to be Redo, is now entirely different. Control-Y is now Proof, what is it called? Proof Setup, or... says up here, proof colors. So your proof colors are determined off here in proof setup. And right now I have it set to custom, which is, if you do device to simulate here, it's gonna be gray gamma. There's way too many different ones to even occupy your brain. There's Epson gray gamma. I don't know what that is. Gray gamma works just fine. You can do either one of these. I honestly don't know the difference. So you choose one of those, say okay, and now when you hit Control Y, it toggles. And this is super useful to your workflow because in every other artistic discipline that uses painting of any kind, like whether it's user interface design, environment design, character design, it's super valuable to check your values. Get it? So checking your values ensures that your focal points are right and that your contrast is working and all that's coming together in spite of whatever colors are on top of it. And if you use other techniques, especially in old Photoshop, older Photoshop, like if you just, you know, change it using like image adjustments, like hue saturation, and you just strip the saturation out. Especially older versions of Photoshop, like it doesn't actually give you an accurate representation of what a desaturated thing is. Also, it's not easy to toggle it on and off the way it is with Control Y. So I would just recommend using that trick, Control Y, super, super handy. Okay, so I wanna also talk about selecting layers a little bit more. And I wanna find a really soft, feathery layer to do this. So let's maybe look at, where's a nice soft layer? Oh, there's one, why not? So this inner glow has a nice quality to it. Now we learned before that we could lock the alpha channel and then, you know, I can come in here and select my color. Let's say I want it to, I don't know, glow green or something like that. And if I lock the alpha channel, then it will, you know, only paint the same amount of alpha as what was on this fuzzy layer before, right? But there's another technique which is really, really handy, and David Shevlin uses this in his tutorial videos, and that's to control click on a layer. And what that does, it looks like it's only selected half of it. That's because the outline only shows up around where it's 50% opaque or more. 50 up to 100%. And then everywhere else where it's like more subtly transparent, it just doesn't show that outline. But you'll see it still works the same as locking the alpha. And this is actually really handy because I can come in here, I can grow or shrink that selection. Like, you know, we learned before about like select, modify, and then you can like contract or expand it. So that's handy. Or I can, if I undo this, I can go to a new layer. And now on that new layer, I'm painting that same amount of transparency into here, and I can like, you know, do whatever I want. So super handy. I can come along and like smudge it within that, you know, and play around with it. But the transparency and the edging will stay perfect, just the way I want it to. Also, you can do Control H, which we learned about in a previous tutorial, to hide the selection, but it still totally works, same as you would expect. You can do Control H again. You can do Control D to deselect that selection. Or of course, you can do V for the move tool, and you can then move that around. Looks like a, oh nope, that's just on this layer. What? Something didn't get selected. I guess moving is a little spotty. Sorry about that. Okay, so that's a little more on selection and layers. It's, again, it's control clicking on the icon of the layer, not the text. That's important. Finally, there's the F key. I don't think I went over the F key before. F key is nice if you want to just like remove all menus around. You just want to like maximize your screen space, and then you just hit F again and it cycles back through. Sometimes you'll lose menus with the F key. And then there's Liquify. Liquify, I probably should have covered Liquify in the filters tutorial. Let's find a good layer to liquify. That's a great one. Okay, so let's turn all this on. I'm gonna liquify on this. Make sure you're on the layer that you want to liquify. And I'm gonna come over here. And this is the Liquify pop-up. So Liquify is a lot of fun. It's like smudge, but much cleaner. So it keeps the edge fidelity at where it was. And you can really sort of push and pull these shapes however you like. Like, you can come in here and really mess around with it. And it works nicely when you've got darker shapes. If you don't have darker shapes, I guess you could show a backdrop. Yeah, that works. Just click show backdrop, and then that way you know how it's all looking. Whoa. Okay. So, yeah. Turn it off when you're doing this, and then show backdrop when you want to, like, kind of test it out, see what it's doing. And then you just say, when you're done with it, you say okay. And then now you have a distorted, liquefied outcome. It's kind of really handy. So that covers pretty much everything that I use on a daily basis. There's some more advanced stuff, but honestly, guys, like, you're going to be great. You're going to do just fine just with these four videos are going to be plenty for you. I don't think you need to go out and really dive too deep into Photoshop. Yeah, it's a complicated tool. Yeah, things are not intuitive. Hopefully we've circumvented a lot of that through these videos. And hopefully you find enough interest in this stuff that you want to learn how to create these paintings and you sign up for the class. I would love to have you. I'm always open to feedback. I'm always open to having people come and let me know what's working, what they want to see in future classes, etc. So head on over, check it out. And thank you so much for all your support and for watching. And good luck making awesome visual effects.